Greetings! In this video I want to introduce you to some very interesting new harmonicas that I've been developing in the past couple of years. The thing they all have in common is that they link two diatonic harmonicas together to do something new and special. And they come in a bunch of different types, so I'll start with the simplest one and then move forward from there. Okay, well the first one I want to show you is my octaharp. It's a stacked octaharp. It's basically got two harmonicas, one above the other, tuned an octave apart. A lot of the manufacturers these days are making low versions of their harmonicas, and so what I've done here is basically take the low version and the normal version and just put them together, and they sound fantastic together. Let me show you. So this is a Suzuki version in the key of C. It's just a normal C and a low C put together. So you see, you get that beautiful, big, rich octave effect. And what I've done here is I've just taken the Suzuki reed plates with absolutely no work, no retuning or anything, and they just sound perfectly in tune. And you can do the same with the Hohner, the normal Hohner models, and then the Hohner Thunderbird. So this is a standard G marine band deluxe on top, and then it's the Thunderbird on the bottom, the low G. I've actually tuned this one in Paddy Richter tuning. So it's great for playing traditional Irish tunes, and you get that lovely rich octave sound. That's, I think that's in A minor, maybe in G. Okay, here's a sidle version, and this is tuned in normal D and low D, and this one's also in Paddy Richter tuning. Now there's a few little things about these octave harps that I should talk about. Basically, they work best with full valving. You can just try throwing a normal Thunderbird and a normal harp in there, but there'll be a lot of air loss because you know you've got double the number of reeds. Now you can, if you did some selective embossing, very good embossing, that would reduce that and reed gapping. But they still sound better with full valving. In order to make that easy, I've come up with my own stealth valves. I call them stealth valves because basically, once they're in the harp, you don't know they're in there. They lay flat, they don't give you any trouble, and they're very quiet and very easy to install. So I've come up with a whole system for how to install them, and it only takes a few minutes to install accurately a complete set of valves on a diatonic harmonica. I'll be showing that in another video. As well, I've come up with my own special range of power combs, diatonic power combs, which have got valve pockets. So it makes it easy to install the valves in these combs without having to, you know, nip the edges of the backs of the valves so they don't get pinched between the reed plate and the comb. And I'll be showing all that in another video as well. Now, with the octaharp, you're basically throwing two harps together in the same key, but an octave apart. But of course, with this little housing that I've got, you can actually throw two harps of, some other varieties together. You could have, for instance, a G and a D, and then you'd be playing in fifths. But another really common sound that people use is the tremolo sound. So this is a little tremolo harp. It's made from two diatonic tenor-hole harps for the first time to get that tremolo sound. And it's a sound that you'll recognize as soon as I play it. Okay, it's that sort of accordion kind of sound. And normally you can only get it in special, you know, tremolo harmonicas that you have to buy. And they're kind of a little bit awkward and unwieldy for people who don't usually play them. So now you can play it with a normal hole spacing of a 10-hole harp. And what it is just two harmonicas slightly detuned from each other. So there's a standard tuning and another one tuned slightly sharp. Obviously, that has to be done by you, or if you buy the sidle version, you can actually specify the amount of extra you know, raised tuning in the second harmonica. So that would save a lot of work. The next harmonica I want to show you looks a little bit different. Instead of the harmonicas being stacked one above the other, they're actually in line. And I call this my selectable octaharp. It's still an octave harmonica, but you can actually select between single notes or octave playing. And the way you do that is that the harps move with respect to each other. There's little magnets here holding them in each location, and when the harmonicas are like that, you get all the reeds playing, the front and the back harmonica. But when you move them out of line, the holes are blocked between the two harmonicas, and then you just get the front harmonica, and you can add all your familiar sort of bending and stuff like that. And then go to the octave. And you can do that quite quickly. You just have to move them with your thumb like that as you're playing. It gives you a lot of extra flavor in your playing, because you can switch from one sound and then get a bigger fat octave sound. So I'll try and illustrate that. Okay, now these are just standard reed plates. I haven't done any embossing on them. They would work better with some embossing, but I just threw it together, and so I'm just showing you with the standard reed plates. The front harmonica is half valved, so that means you can get all your normal bends. And the rear harmonica is full valved. It just works better that way. I've got the valving system really well worked out for these. So that's the selectable octaharp. So that's in the key of D. Here's a lower one. This is in the key of A.